Hey y'all, it's Shannon. So I wanted to come at you with my 2016 favorites. Yes, I realize it's almost February. In fact, this may go up in February. But I still wanted to do this because I always think it's fun to see what people's favorites are and why they are their favorites, basically. My beauty favorites, I guess, for 2016 are comprised of hair, a little bit of makeup, and then mostly skincare. So if you want to skip on to skincare, you can certainly feel free to do so. But I'm going to go through hair stuff first because I don't use a lot of hair product, but I take really good care of my hair. My sister is a cosmetologist and has been for 20 plus years and would yell at me if I didn't. So I think that's a good reason to take care of it. So the first thing I'm going to talk about, I don't have with me, but they're in the shower. I just didn't want to go get them because they're wet and they'll get all over the place, is my shampoo and conditioner. So I love Alterna. I'm a big fan of them with a small exception of one line I've tried I did not like at all. However, everything else I've tried from there is amazing. And the other lines I've tried are the anti-aging, which is the deep replenishing moisturizing and volumizing one. And then they have one that is the red clover anti-aging, or for people with hair loss. So like if you had weight loss surgery and about 6 months out, you started crapping your pants because you started losing all your hair. It's a good one to try. However, I'm gonna tell you this is a sad story because Alterna has discontinued that. You can still buy it online in certain places, but it is no longer being made, so it's not available. However, on the bright sunshiny side, Redken has made one that is a very similar formula, is my understanding, and I haven't tried it out, but the lady at Cosmoprof was telling me about it, and I think we've ordered it for my mom, and my mom will get to try it. So the other thing I am crazy about is hair masks, and this is helps if it's the right way. This is also from Alterna. I tried other brands. I didn't like the other ones I tried. So this is the Caviar Anti-Aging Overnight Hair Rescue Repair While You Sleep. So it is a leave-in conditioner, leave-in hair mask, basically. I really, really like this. I think this is wonderful. They also make another one that is, again, in the shower, but I don't want to pull it out because it's nasty and it's wet. I'm not dealing with that tonight. And it is the Caviar Anti-Aging, I want to say the Fill and Fix Mask. I'll insert a picture here and I'll also insert pictures of the shampoo and conditioner lines that I've been using from Alterna. The Red Clover Shampoo and the Anti-Aging Moisture Replenishing Conditioner. Because one is the red bottle and one is the purple bottle. The other thing I really love, and if you've seen my empties in the last year or two, you know I really like this. This is the Redken Fifth Avenue Diamond Oil Shatterproof Shine. This stuff is beautiful on your hair. I just put a little on the ends and, you know, run it through, and it's just wonderful. It really, really helps if your ends are dry, and I love it, love it. And this big old bottle will last me forever, long time. So next we're moving on to makeup. Just pretend I could do like a fancy intro and it looked like really pretty and I was like, what? And there were like unicorns jumping about or something, I don't know. So the next thing I'm gonna talk about is my makeup. And this year, I did buy a few things, but the main thing I really fell in love with this year, and I only bought two of them. I only bought two eyeshadow palettes this year at all, period. Now, I was given a couple others, but I only bought two with my own dinero. So that's saying something. And part of the reason I haven't even bothered to buy any of the others is because they are Viseart. So when Muse Beauty Pro was having their, I want to say it was like somewhere between February and May, some sort of sale, I picked up the neutral matte one and the sultry muse, which is the 05 palette, and I see what all the fuss is about. I've always had kind of crepey eyelids. It's always difficult to blend eyeshadow on my eyelids. However, you know, I know it's not me. I know it's not the brushes, because I've done makeup on other people for proms and weddings or whatnot, although skincare is my jam, but I've done it. And I know it blends much better on other people. This one though, this is an actual brand of eyeshadow that blends amazingly on my eyelids. I should take it back. I did buy three palettes technically, because after I tried these and fell in love with them, I bought the Theory palette in I think it's cashmere. It's the number two. So it's the warm toned one. And I really love it. I take it to travel everywhere I go. But these are amazing. And what I really like about these, especially this neutral matte one, is it's one that literally I have, you can look on it. I have used every color. I've dug into every color. This is, that's an amazing palette. So for me personally, you know, I don't know about anyone else, but these were a good investment because I literally can use every single color. I would also like to, in the future, get the dark mattes and the neutral mattes, and then there's another couple of shimmer palettes I want. Their shimmers are beautiful, but I agree, their mattes are where it's at for them. It is amazing. Now we're gonna get into skincare. So I will suggest that you may need to pause this video here and go get yourself a tea, a coffee, a Coke, a water, and some popcorn or something. Because this one's going to be a little while, because I fell in love with a whole lot of brands this year and a whole lot of products, I really should say. So I made a big list. Very excited about this. So it's just too much in general. I really, really love my skincare. I was an esthetician for 10 years, and while I did do makeup, the majority of my focus was on skincare, facials, and machining and things like that. So I really am a big fan of skincare. So, one brand, if you follow me on Instagram, you know I love this brand. You know it. And that is The Ordinary. So The Ordinary is an offshoot of Deciem, the Abnormal Beauty Company. And it is just lower than drugstore prices, but very effective products. And you have to have some sort of knowledge of skincare, or knowledge of, I guess, beauty products or skincare, really I should say skincare products, and what they're used for and when to use them, how to use them. Otherwise, although they do have guides, you may be a little lost in it. I'm just gonna say that. I was like, because it can get confusing with the terminology and some of that. However, I picked two products out of all the ones I tried that I really liked. I was trying to narrow it down, and I have all of my products literally like sitting here. I was like, that the two products I really fell in love with from Deciem or The Ordinary are the Buffet and the Vitamin C Suspension at 23% with the HA of a 2%. I really, really like this. I think if you are looking for a reasonably priced vitamin C serum, this is the one. However, I will tell you, it does sting. You will have a tingle. It's gonna do that, and it's gonna feel a little like rough and pilly, like not pilly, but like there's, you know, because it is a suspension, so you do feel the like the powder, I guess. It's a powder that's suspended. It's a suspended powder. Yeah, there's no other way to say that. So it's water-free, it's a stable suspension, it's really nice, $5.80. Do you know the other best, like, vitamin C serum I've tried is like 90 some odd dollars. So for that one to be $5.80 and be as effective as it is and be as good as it is at that price, you can't beat it if you're on a budget and you have to watch what you spend. However, I will just say that it does sting. Sorry about that. I had products dropping everywhere. Now the Buffet. This I tried before I tried the vitamin C suspension. I tried this when I tried their hyaluronic acid. I tried their retinoid, their lactic, their Matrixyl. So the Buffet is basically like a really nice anti-aging serum. Like really, really nice. Like as much as this costs, and it's $14.80. I have other serums that I have tried that cost four or five times as much that I don't like as much. I will say this though is amazeballs. It's beautiful. It's got a multi-peptide technology. It's got Seneca. It's got Matrixyl Synth 6, 3. It's got a whole bunch of peptides, amino acids, all the good things your skin needs long term. But then the Seneca, what is really nice with that is it helps to relax your muscles. So this helps with both static and dynamic lines over time. And I really, really like it because when I use it, I feel like it's not like I can't like make expressions, because I mean, I'm an expressive person anyways, and those lines are just always going to be there, but it helps to relax them just a little bit and they're not as noticeable. So I really like that for $14.80. I can tell you, I will continue to repurchase it. And as you can tell, I've shown it a lot of love, and that she's almost gone. So God tier. Next two products, I feel like if I didn't include them, someone should ask me why I did not. And that is from Missha. So, you know, I love my Asian beauty. However, I will say this year, I did have a huge love affair with French pharmacy brands. We have been enjoying ourselves. So, I love the Time Revolution First Treatment Essence, and I love the Night Repair Ampoule. These together, massive powerhouse. Love them, love them, love them. So this is one of the, these are just those ingredients that if you don't use them in your skin routine or ritual, whatever you want to call it, you miss them when they're not there. Like your skin, my skin's not as luminous. It's a little duller. It's not, the texture's not as good, but this stuff is just beautiful. I mean, it just helps. And when you put this on and then you put other serums on top of it, because of the fermented ingredients, it really helps to make those serums even more effective and just kind of boost them. So I really enjoy using these two products together, like I said, and they are wonderful. So the next line is Bioderma. So I know everyone loves them for their micellar water. I really don't care about that, to be honest. What I really like is their hydrabio line. So this is their line for people that are dry, dehydrated. Eat me. So, or at least right now, in the last several months. Well, always dehydrated, but not always dry. Normal dehydrated. This stuff is really great. So this is the hydrabio serum in the moisture concentrate, and this is the hydrabio in the gel cream. You can get this at either Essential, or you can get this on Beautylish. Beautylish now carries these, and these are very reasonably priced. Drugstore prices at $25 for a serum is a good price, and the gel cream I think is approximately the same. I did get the cream because they have a cream in it. I really liked it. I thought the texture was really nice, but it was a little heavy. I gave it to my mom. My mom loves that stuff. So Madara is a brand that I had been scoping out for several months. It's a Latvian brand. It's just one of those things, like sometimes I stumble on brands through the internet or people, you know, suggest it or whatever, and I really like that. And so I just kind of research it because research is part of my job, and so I'm pretty good at it and I like to research. So Madara is a Latvian brand, but what intrigued me about them was their dry oils. They're superseed dry oils. So basically they're serum oils and they're dry oils. So they're really, really nice. So I have two of them. I had three, but I had the hydration one. However, after I had it for all of 3 days, it took a big kersplash in the sink. So I was able to save a little and I've been eking it out for the last few weeks, but like sadly it passed on and died. So these are the two serums I have tried for a few months now, and I really like both of them. And you just need a little bit, goes a long, long way, and I love these. And so the Madara Superseed Age Recovery, this one is geared more towards people who are a little older, have signs of aging, wrinkles, sun damage, a lot of that sort of thing. And it is really those for with more mature, tired skin. And I just really like it. I like the ingredients in it. So it's got carrot, cranberry, raspberry, strawberry, tomato, rowanberry, blackcurrant, St. John's wort, and sea buckthorn, and then rosehip oil. So it's really, really nice. They're all dry oils, and it's fabulous. I will say, however, I like the smell, but it took a little getting used to, but it does smell a little bit like fruit that's kind of on the verge of being overripe, if that makes sense. So I'm okay with that, because to me it smells like a little, slightly like overripe strawberries a little bit to me. That's what it smells like. That's all I can tell you. And the other thing is if you are very interested and very concerned with what goes into your products, where they come from, things like that, this is an actual EcoCert company. So EcoCert is a third-party certification that goes through testing to make sure that where things are sourced and how they are made and how the company even processes them. So EcoCert is a really, really good brand, good certification. In fact, it is my understanding that it is one of the hardest ones for people in the beauty and skincare industry to get. So it is good. And these are not crazy priced. These aren't $165. These are 46 euros, and if you order it from the site after, I want to say after 45 euros, you get free shipping. So 46 euros at this point in time approximates out to about $50 to $52, depending on what the exchange rate is. And you can catch these on sale sometimes, and they are carried on Look Fantastic and Love Lula as well. So I will say I do love these. My favorite of these two, probably for me personally, is the Superseed Radiant Energy Oil. So this one has 9 Superseed oils, where that one has 10, and they do not have the exact same combination of oils, so that is just something to keep in mind, because I tend to layer product a lot. So this one is really nice. It's got all sorts of antioxidants, different vitamins, and it's got blueberry, cranberry, cloudberry, blackberry, black cumin, parsley seed, pumpkin borage, golden and golden jojoba, and it is for people with dull, tired skin, lack of glow and luster, and then lack of elasticity and firmness and the first signs of aging. So again, so this is sort of to help prevention. This is to turn back time, okay, I'm done with that, I promise. But I really do like both of these. I think they are wonderful, and the little bit I've eked out of the one bottle that I was able to save part of it, I really enjoy the hydration serum, and I can tell you I will be purchasing that one in this new year at some point in time. It's gonna happen. Darphin or Darphin, I'm not sure how it's pronounced. I'm pretty sure it's Darphin, because when I went into a Blue Mercury to ask for a couple of samples and to buy some lip balm that I needed, they had some folks from Darphin there, and they were calling it Darphin, so that's what I'm going with. So Darphin is a, I don't know if it's a French pharmacy brand. I know you can get it in some French pharmacies, but they'd be higher end. So this is a French pharmacy, French spa type brand. And Darphin, I believe, is under the Lauder house. And it is so beautiful. I love the smell of this. I just, everything I've tried from Darphin is amazing. And it's a treat. Like, I save up and I buy it, it's a treat. Or if I catch it on Essential on sale every once in a while, like Black Friday, I bought full size. It's a treat, and I love it. So everything I've tried from there, I feel bad. I was like, everything I've tried. I've tried some of their serums, but what I really fell in love with this last year that I tried, and I even bought full size of, and so for me to say that, because these are not the least expensive products. Now granted, I wait and I watch until they're on sale, and then I purchase them, but they're still not the least expensive. The aromatic cleansing balm with rosewood. If I have a headache, if I have a sinus problem, this stuff is great. Now I will say, don't be like me and use too much when you first start using this, because I thought, I took some and I was like, it didn't rub. It didn't, you know, break, like, oil out like I was thinking it was. No, this is a second cleanse. This is a morning cleanse. Do not use this to take your makeup off. It is not meant for that. This is meant to cleanse your skin. So how you use this is you slightly dampen the face after you've removed any makeup or anything, and then you take just a tiny bit, and then you rub it all over, and she just makes your skin feel like fresh bloomed daisies. I don't know. It's just a wonderful feeling. It is a wonderful, wonderful cleanser. The other thing I have tried from Darphin and fallen in love with, when I ordered this, I got some deluxe sample sizes, and I got to try the Hydraskin Light. And Darphin, when they give you sample sizes, they give you good size samples that are gonna last you probably, depending on who you are and how much of a, I guess, a heavy-handed person you are, how long they're gonna last you. But mine, I actually keep in my travel bag, and I have a couple more that I was able to get from other places that were giving samples. So I fell in love with this Darphin Hydraskin Light Gel Cream. This stuff is so beautiful, so beautiful. Now I've tried Sunday Riley's Tidal enzyme jelly thing, and that's nice. It's really light, it's wonderful, but I feel like this gives me just a little more hydration. It's very light, it's very beautiful, and it's got a 24-month shelf life once it's open, so that's wonderful. I really, really love this stuff, and I was able to pick it up at Essential. It was one of their Black Friday deals, so I wasn't gonna turn that down at that price because I know what it is regularly. The other thing I have fallen in love with from Darphin, again, like, they gave me samples and now I'm like, oh, I got to get full size. So I have already ordered full sizes of this. So, and I have another little tiny one. So this is, I guess I'll show you the tiny one so you can see it. This is the Darphin Lumierre Essentiel Illuminating Oil Serum. I've really been into oil serums this year, as you should be able to tell thus far from, like, Madara and stuff. This one is just so beautiful. It really does give your skin a nice luminous finish. It is amazing. So I love it. And then in conjunction with this, which is the Darphin Lumiere Essentiel Illuminating Oil Gel Cream, which I love. It's got the word oil, it's got the word gel, it's got the word cream. It's like, oh my God, it's everything in one. It smells amazing. I've used a lot of it. But now, I use this not as what a regular person probably uses it for. A regular person or a normal person is going to probably use this as their last finishing step. I do not do that. No. No, no sir, no ma'am. So what I do is I use these as little, like what I call little boosters to each other. And so I'll use this and then I'll use a little bit of this and I do thin layers of both. And then I'll continue on my merry way with whatever other serums or moisturizers. And I'm just telling you, for me, it works fabulous. Again, I've ordered full size of this and the serum. And I think together, they are just a magical powerhouse for your skin. And I love them. That's all I can tell you. Alchemist probably makes the best cleanser I've tried this year, and I've tried a lot of cleansers. So it's one of the more natural green type of ones. It's a gentle gel facial cleanser with geranium leaf, bergamot, and rosebud. It smells so good. Ah, I love it, and it doesn't dry my skin out. So I don't know if it's just my age or the fact that I moved to an extremely dry climate, but I used to be able to use like drugstore type of cleansers and be okay. No more does my skin say, because, well, with the exception of I can buy an Asian like drugstore priced cleanser and it will work fine and dandy. But I will say, if I go like into my local like grocery store or Walmart or Target or whatever, and I was like, I buy a cleanser, it's 99 out of 100 times it's gonna dry my skin out, and I can't have that. It hurts so bad. It's dry, it's tight, it's uncomfortable. I'm not having that. So this is the Gentle Gel Facial Cleanser from Grown Alchemist. This stuff is amazing. This and their lip balm. This lip balm is so beautiful. It's watermelon and vanilla lip balm. It's amazing. It's like a gel. If your lips are sore, if your lips are hurt, she's going to make it feel better. But this, my skin is not tight ever. And I do have other cleansers I really like, but sometimes, like, if I use them, I'll still feel tight sometimes. Not always, but sometimes. But this one, and then the Arcana white tea one, which I keep in my travel bag. I need to do a travel best of 2016 all by itself, because I just have so many of those that I take with me that are very specific to that. I like those two. These, they're just the best. My skin never feels dry with this. I am having a hard time tracking down a full size of this, because I have been on the hunt. And I'm not having good luck with that. So I'm bummed. So Ren Skincare is a UK brand or British brand. And I love this Vitamineral Omega-3 Optimum Skin Oil. So it's got omegas 3, 6, 9, and I want to say rice bran milk? Something along those lines. And it's just fabulous. Fabulous. So I got a small a travel set, and I traveled with it, and like it was just one of those things that the first time I used it, I was like, what? Oh my God. Holy crap. My skin just felt instantly hydrated and plumped, and it just helped to fill in some fine lines, and it was just one of those things. My skin had a glow, and it was just beautiful and effortless, and I was like, man, I need this in full size. I have this, and in fact, in my cart where I have the Darphin Lumiere Essentiel, I'm also ordering a backup of this because, yes, I love it that much that I will continue to use it. And I will say a shout out to all of their masks, and if there are like other hydrating products, really quick, they are wonderful, they are beautiful, but I would say for me personally that the Omega-3 Optimum Skin Serum is amazing. And if you are looking for a semi-reasonably priced serum in the U.S., in that $45 range, this is a good one to try. It's got good skin, good for your skin stuff, and it is amazing. And I'm already working my way through that one. I just really love it. It's so beautiful. It's just one of those things, I just love it. I feel like one of the top brands I've really fallen in love with this year, although I feel like I've fallen in love with so many brands or products, maybe products are a better word, is Kate Somerville. I'm like, never ever in my life have I gotten those stupid little sachet packets? And you know what I'm talking about because you get them all the time and you don't use them half of the time. But I was involved in an Instagram thing in November where they were like, you know, it was the packet, like it was the sample November sample challenge. So it was to use up all your samples or as many as you could. And so I was like, okay. So I had some from Kate Somerville because I got a little travel pack, a try me pack, and I was like, I absolutely fell in love with the Quench Serum because I got a little 5 mL sample of that, and I'm like, I keep travel versions of that around all the time, and I bought full size. I have a backup of this. I love this so much, and for me to buy a backup, that's crazy because this is beautiful, and once again, it's one of those things that when I put it on my skin, it just instantly plumps, it instantly hydrates, and this together, like, I combine, like, y'all, I layer serums, I do lots and lots of thin layers. I'm very European in my style of skincare, I guess, or European and Asian mixed together somehow, because I have a gajillion steps, but I layer a lot of serums together, and for me, it just works really well, and this and the Omega 3, they play well together, and it's beautiful. This is one of those things that when I put it on my skin, it instantly hydrates, it instantly illuminates. It just helps to fill in any fine lines. Like, I carry it all the way up to right underneath my eyes. This is beautiful stuff. I mean, gorgeous. Now, that being said, I have never in my life tried a single sample packet of skincare and tried it, went to bed, woke up the next day and said, holy crap, my face looks amazing. It's glowy, it's well rested, it looks wonderful. That cannot be said anymore. So I tried a sample of the Kate Somerville Redosphere Micro Peel and I thought, holy crap, this can't be. I was traveling for work basically, and so I stopped and I had gotten another sample and I tried it again and I had the same reaction. I was like, oh my god, my skin looks amazing when I use this. So this is the Kate Somerville Redosphere Micro Peel. This is retinol glycolic treatment. This is $90, so this is not going to be in everybody's budget, but the way I look at this, in my mind, this equates out to a 2-for-1. So this is a glycolic. So it does the glycolic peel, and then it's got a time-release retinol in it, and it is beautiful, and I love it. However, that being said, you cannot use this every night. This is an every other night type of deal at the most. My skin can handle it about 3 nights a week, and my skin is fairly used to cosmeceutical-grade glycolic and acids at this point in my life. When I really want to look super-duper fly, I use this, or else I will use the Sunday Riley products. I have also never fallen in love instantly in love with any sort of moisturizer I've tried from a packet. Yet again, Kate Somerville, you've like knocked me in the nuts. Well, not in the nuts, but you know what I mean. It's just, it's amazing. Like, I do not do this. I do not purchase full size just from a sample packet. Yes, I did. I tried sample packets and then I really liked it. So I went into like a Sephora and I said, yo, can I get some samples? And so I tried it again because I thought after one try and I was like, holy macaroni, this is amazing. It's lightweight. It's beautiful. It just sinks into my skin so wonderfully. I thought this cannot be. This is just like a one-time weirdo shot. So I was like, I got it. I went in and I got some samples from other places. And I was like, I tried it again and I was like, okay. So when Caroline Hirons, God bless you, love you very much, had got a coupon code for Kate Somerville for 30% off, thus you see all the Kate Somerville because, you know, otherwise I think these are $65, but I will say I do love these, and around the holidays you can get like gift set packages, so that makes these a little more, you know, affordable type of thing. So I really, really like Kate Somerville moisturizers, and I also love her Age Arrest one that came in my travel kit. I have like three. I gave one to my mom for Christmas. Those are the best like little Christmas presenty gifts to give people. They love them. My mom thinks she's spoiled now. Big fan. Thank you, Kate Somerville. And also a big thank you to the customer service. Every time I have a question or call or email, like seriously, 5-star customer service. Like, I've never experienced it. Customer service the way I have there. I can't say enough good things about them. So, Biologique Rechange P50 Lotion P50 1970. I feel like everyone, this is on their favorite. It's amazing. Thank you, Caroline Hirons, again, for introducing this to me and to the world and to all of us, because it is super duper duper wonderful. And on that note, I'm also going to say thank you again, because I found Miramaya through Caroline Hirons, and I really do like this gentle exfoliating toner. When my skin just really has had it and says a poo on you and we're done, this is a really nice that's a really nice gentle exfoliating toner that I can use pretty much no matter what, and it doesn't cause my skin any irritation. And I really also like her SPF 20 moisturizer, but again, I really need to do one for my travel stuff. I'm pointing down here because I have to travel again. So who knows when this will get to go up. Who can say? So from my Asian brands, DHC, which is a Japanese brand, fell in love with their CoQ10 lotion and their milk. I really, really like the milk. I use the milk more as a serum than anything else. It is simply fabulous. I love it. Can't say enough about it. Sunday Riley, and that is Good Jeans and Luna. I feel like those really don't need for me to talk a lot about them because they're so well talked about. They're amazing. They're a good powerhouse together. They're great apart, but they're beautiful. You know, the Good Jeans does plump. It does do all of the acid exfoliation, and then you have the fatty retinol in the Luna that is just amazing and wonderful and just helps to with cell turnover, and I love it. Like, I have backups of that too. So Jordan Samuels is a brand I discovered from YouTube, Instagram, Tof Camp, Caroline Hirons, a lot of people. And I really fell in love with his Hydrate Serum. So this is a water-free serum, silicone-free. It is just the coolest texture ever. It's beautiful. I put this on before I put on my vitamin C serum in the morning to buffer it because it stings a lot less. And it's just so beautiful, like texture-wise. And if you are looking for a very reasonably priced hydrating serum that is not from the ordinary, I would say check out Jordan Samuel's line. Plus, his is water-free. It is silicone-free. So if silicone is a problem, you need to check this one out. His are really good, and I know he does deals sometimes on them, so you can get that and the Etoile and his cleanser, and they're all really lovely. But to me, his jammy jam is gonna be that Hydrate Serum. It's amazing. And then last but not least, because I live in a dry climate, I have very dry lips. So I loved my Christian Dior Rose Lip Balm, whatever it's called, I don't know. But I've been trying to find something that is close to it and gives me like the intense like moisturization but hopefully doesn't cost like $30 some odd. And so I've tried this Cutica Intense Lip Repair Balm. I think this is made by Zoya. I think Cutica's a brand by them. I do find this is really nice, and then what I'll do is I'll seal this on with the Grown Alchemist. But I will say, if you're looking for a fairly reasonably priced intensive lip repair balm, because that's what this is thick, y'all, thick, but it is very moisturizing, it is very nice, and I do find it works well. And yeah, so if you stuck with it this far, thank you so much. I really appreciate it, and I think we all deserve a cookie for sticking around. So you can go get your cookie now, I guess. Anyways, no, I do appreciate you watching. If you have any suggestions for like products you want to see me try or any products you think I would like, let me know in the comments section below. And if nothing else, let me know also what some of your favorite products were from 2016. I love learning about new brands. Like I said, I've tried several and I have several more I really want to try. I'm really into the French brands right now though. So the French, and I'm going back to Korean. My Asian skincare brands, because I found several other like products I really want to try that I'm like, ooh, I need you in my life. Yes. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this. I'll talk to you later. Do me a huge favor, like and subscribe, and see you later. Bye bye.